I'm going to take you through the Agent Builder experience, which is part of your Microsoft 365 Copilot license, and it allows any user, no skill required, to start building their own agents. Let's just level set on a couple of the concepts here so that you know what we're doing and why we're doing it. This is Copilot, Microsoft 365 Copilot. I'm in the work experience here, and this is my starting point for all of my AI experiences. But what if I want to tweak it a bit, customize it a bit, have it work for just a specific business process flow or to automate a specific thing that I do at work? That's where agents come in. And what I'm showing you now is sort of the first early release of this. There's plenty more coming. Please subscribe to the channel if you're interested in this kind of thing. I'm all over it, and there's going to be plenty more content coming. And I really believe this is a most important part of what we need to learn and understand going into the future of AI at work. Enough of the hype, let's take a look. I'm starting here in my business chat experience, which you can access through the Microsoft365.com app, which I'm doing here, or from inside Teams. You'll see you've got a couple of options over the side here. One is get Copilot agents and one is create an agent. These two things will lead you to the same place, but one of them is for pre-built things and one of them is build it yourself. If I click through onto the get Copilot agents option, you will land in this page here where you have a bunch of pre-built agents ready to go. You'll see straight away that there's a mixture here of things that are connected to Microsoft, third party, and just general kind of systems. If there's something in here in particular you'd like me to explore further, I'll see if I can get a license of it. So you need licenses for all of these things that you're connecting to. But if some of these are your line of business systems, then I would encourage you to explore them. For now, I'm just going to pick something here. There's one called Ideas, which is something that is just a fairly generic type of agent that I can work with to help me with brainstorming. It doesn't connect to any other sort of licensed service, so we can just choose to add that. You'll go through a similar experience if you choose one of the licensed ones. And now that takes me back to my main BizChat experience, and you'll see it's over the side here. Now at the top, there is already one agent that is always pre-pinned, if you like, the visual creator, which is the one you can use to generate images. I put career coach in there earlier. There's idea coach. If I choose to pin this, it pops up into that other area, and I can choose to unpin it and bring it down there. If I decide there's one there that I don't want anymore, I can simply uninstall it. So this is very easy come, easy go type of stuff about the things that I find useful to have working with me in my Copilot. So here's my idea coach. You'll see that we've got a bunch of suggested prompts that I can start with. So let me just click this and off we go. Now this one is just designed to give you a very quick start on those types of conversations. Where you can get real value out of this though is creating your own agent, and you determine what it is and what it does. So let's take a look at that example here. I'm going to click on create an agent, and this is going to bring up an experience here where we start in natural language to describe something. If you are familiar with Copilot Studio, you'll see some things here, not the least of which is the Copilot Studio at the branding at the top here, but you'll see some things here that are very familiar. This is powered by Copilot Studio. It's a lightweight version of that. So Copilot Studio is the place where you can build out agents to go externally. You've got full sophisticated control over adding all sorts of knowledge and topics. We'll come back to that a little bit later. For now though, this agent builder is a light version of that. This piece that I'm showing you right now is included in your Microsoft 365 Copilot license, and it's designed for everyday business users to create everyday business agents. Now, don't freak out that this is going to get out of control. We will come back to the security and governance at the end, but I really want to show you what we can do with it first. So the first thing is, what would you like to make? What I'm going to do first is show you the idea of just the basics of what it can connect to. So let's say we want to say, create an agent to answer questions about HR policy. Now this is just the typical starting point that everyone wants. Incidentally, Microsoft is actually releasing an employee agent, so you won't need to build this particular one, but just sort of to show you a starting point and then to show you something different that you can do it. So tells you that it's suggested a name, which seems perfectly reasonable. Now, immediately, as soon as I've done that, it's given it a name. So here's my name at the top here. And it's also given me some of these suggested prompts. And the next thing Let's refine the instructions. What should be emphasized or avoided? So we'll just say, please maintain a professional tone. Professional demeanor, there you go. You gotta love auto, gotta love autofill. I've spelt that wrong, but I think it will understand it anyway. Yes, it has. Okay. So it should be friendly. What we'll get to in a moment, once we've answered the questions, I do not have any further refinements, is that it's going to say, okay, that's finished. Don't just stop there though, because all that's done so far is just give you these suggested prompts. So the agent at this point is almost just like the sort of just a shell of suggested prompts, which is a little bit like what that ideas one or the career coach one is doing, which is fine, helps you sort of start the conversation, but we can do better than that. I want you to click on this little configure tab. And again, you'll see some Copilot Studio things here. So this has brought in a description. We can change the icon. We'll come back to that one in a minute. It's got instructions about what it's doing. You can see it's picked up those things from the conversation we just had. But let's come down here and now we have knowledge. So you can choose to say, I want to add a SharePoint URL or just come in here and browse. So if I've got a nicely curated SharePoint library of human resources documents, which is really what you need here, I'm just going to, for this example, choose the whole library. I'm going to come back and show you something more specific in a moment. We can put that one in there. And then I can also choose, do I want this to be grounded on web content or not? I'm just going to choose not, and then we'll let it go while I keep talking here. Your Microsoft 365 Copilot work experience by default, unless your admin has switched this capability off, which they can do, is grounded in all of your documents and also grounded in the web. So what I'm saying now is I'm basically creating an agent here, which is scoped right down. I'm saying I want an agent that is just looking at that particular folder in SharePoint and nothing else. It's not going to look at my emails or my Teams chats. It's not going to be grounded in the web because I've switched that off. So this is one example of something you might do with it just to create a really refined scope agent. Please look at this. You can imagine if you had a folder of documents about a particular project that a team was working on, you could create an agent that just chats about what's going on with that project. So rather than that experience sometimes in the Microsoft 365 Copilot where you ask questions and you have to make it find the right thing, this gives you that really grounded, landed starting point of a very specific thing. So we're going to just leave that one aside because I want to show you something that is more specific and more tailored and I think a little bit more valuable. Let's go through this experience again and create an agent. And this time what I'm going to do is something that is around an offsite that we've got coming up. We've got an end of year trip that's a conference and a bit of a reward for our staff. And we are going to go to Slovenia. It's just my favorite place to talk about right now. So it gives us a name. Now let's say I don't like the name. I want to call it Slovenia Fabulous Trip Guide. And then it will change the name. Did you notice up there? It changed the name. Now it is giving us these suggested prompts again. But what I'm going to do at this point is give it a little bit more information. So I am actually going to connect this to two specific documents. I'm going to connect it to a policy document, which is all about travel and expense policy. And then I'm going to connect it to another document in a different SharePoint folder that is about things to do. So rather than just going, here's one folder, like we saw in the previous example, this one is going to be very specific. I want you to use these different things. So I'm going to come in here to start with and put some more instructions in, which gives it a bit more information about this is fun, please use emojis. You'll see I'm also giving it instructions here that if someone asks about expenses and policies, please get it from that document. I haven't told it which documents yet, so that's so good, so far so good. Again, we're going to come into this configure tab and you can see what's happened. I could edit these instructions, by the way, if anything wasn't quite fun. So I don't really want it to emphasize that it's a fun conference. I'm going to say, remember, this is a fun conference, right? I don't want it to kind of shove that front and center all the time. So now what I'm going to do is browse, and instead of choosing a whole folder like I did before, I'm going to come in and say for this particular agent, which is just a sort of a moment in time thing about what we're doing, I am going to bring in my most recent version of my travel and expenses policy. And you can see now it's instead of kind of finding that whole folder. It's just put that one thing in there. And then I can come back in and browse and add something else. So I've got a conference site here and I've got a PDF with information about things to do. Actions coming soon. This is something that you will be able to include in here to say that you want it to actually do something for you. I'll come back when that's available. But for now, you have to go to the full Copilot Studio experience. Right now, at the time of recording, you can't actually link up and build it there and bring it back. So just watch this space. There'll be something more coming soon. For now, the capability is about bringing the knowledge and the instructions and the tone and behavior into the experience. I can choose to say, do I want it to have an image generator in there? Do we want it to allow people to generate images as well? Sure, why not? Let's do that. And don't forget, I might want to say, do I want it to have web content? So in this case, I'm going to say yes, because we're encouraging people to explore things to do. We've got a document there, but I also want it to be grounded in the web so that people can find other answers. The other thing here is that these starter prompts are all editable. So let's say we have what transportation options are available, and I don't want that one in there because it's actually not going to be relevant. We've also not got the schedule prepared yet, and we are going to maybe change the, move that one as well. And then you could add additional ones in there. So I've brought this right down so that it's just got these three in there, but you can edit and change that as you like. And you can also bring an icon in here. This needs to be PNG format and less than 1 meg. So we'll just go in here and click change icon. Incidentally, if you do want to create icons, this is something you can actually do, is to use the visual creator agent within your Microsoft 365 Copilot, and that will use designer behind the scenes to come up with an icon for you. I think this one captures it quite well. Let's grab that one and download that to something quite cute there and save that one. And now let's go ahead and click create. Before I do that, you can actually test it in here as well. So I could say, what is the travel allowance per day? And let's just see that it's going to actually check the right thing there. It should refer to the travel document. So you can work on this and then refine those instructions and refine those prompts if you like. I did give it instructions saying to make sure that if the answer wasn't there, that it would refer to the manager. What is the allowance for a dinner? And so there you go. This time it's actually giving us the answer. Now the references will be a little bit clearer when we actually create this thing. So let's go ahead and do that. This takes a minute or so. And then what we're going to do is we're going to find that that experience is inside the Microsoft 365 Copilot in the same way as we saw earlier when we were choosing from the pre-built agents that you can select from. At this stage, this is just my little personal agent, but I'll show you in a moment that we can choose to share it with other people in the organization as well. All right, there we go. So this link only works for you. I can change the share settings here. So if I come in and have a look at that, then I can choose to say this link works for anyone in the organization, specifically via a security group. So let's say this is the whole organization doing this, and let's save that. So now I could copy that link and make it available to other people as well. Let's close that and close it down. Now, here it is on the side. Let's pin that to the top and click through. And there is my agent with its little icon and all of the details. So let's click on this prompt and see. Now, I've actually put in here a document that has a PDF document that has lots of things to do. That's the one of the things that we did, but I've also allowed it to be grounded in the web. So you'll see what it's doing here is responding both ways from the internal work sources, that's hard to say 10 times fast. We've got that in there and you can see there's the reference to that document, but it's also bringing information from the public website. So you're getting a bit of a mix of both. Can I book premium economy? And that's something that should be in the travel and expenses policy. So you'll see straight away, it even knows I'm looking for the travel and expenses policy because that's what I put in the instructions, that it knows that that's what I'm supposed to find. And so there we go. It's giving us that information. It's pointing to that policy. It's giving me all of the details I need to go in there. Now, I've only given it the web. I've given it that PDF document, and I've given it this travel and expenses policy. This is not connected to the rest of my data. It's not connected to the rest of the Microsoft Graph the same way the main Copilot is. If I come in and say, what is our grievance policy, which is in the HR documents, but certainly not in the travel and expenses policy and actually not part of the scope of this agent, it's actually going to give a generic answer and say, please check with the HR department, and not be able to give the answer. Whereas let's copy this just to show you the difference and go back to my main Copilot experience and ask, what's our grievance policy? It should be able to find that, because this Copilot, my Microsoft 365 Copilot, is grounded in all the business data. Let's say now that we've got some more information about the conference, we've sorted out the accommodation arrangements, and I need to go back and edit this, or for any other changes that you wanted to make just to improve the performance. The way that you can get back to this is go back into the Create an Agent, and then from the top here where it says My Copilot Agent, do a drop down and view all agents if it's not the last one that you accessed. And you can see I've got a bunch of them in there. There's my Slovenia Fabulous Trip Guide, and I can click on Edit, come in here back to Knowledge, and let's browse. And now in the conference documents, I also want to add that extra document. Because I defined the scope of this one as just those two documents I put in at the start, and let's update that. Because I defined this as the just those two documents I put in the start, adding something else into that SharePoint folder didn't automatically go in there. Whereas that first one I created that pointed to a whole SharePoint folder, it would still pick up updates to the SharePoint folder. So choose the level of control that you want over those things. Confirmation message. Go to agent, and now it will also be able to answer questions about accommodation. So what we've done here is create an agent that is very narrow in scope, connected to specific knowledge, and soon we will be able to use this to create actions. Microsoft is thinking of this as something where every business user should be able to do this. There are policies, admin policies, where you can switch off this functionality. Please don't start with that. Please let people have a go with this. This is the future of how we're going to work. This is all secured and controlled within your tenant. It's not running away with things. It's not leaking data anywhere else in the system. The other option you've got for building agents, these ones are at the moment quite basic, but once actions come in here, there'll be a little bit more sophistication and capability for things that you can do. But the other thing that's been announced is this is the main Copilot Studio. Now this one, if you want to do it this way, you do need a separate license for Copilot Studio. But here you've got a lot more functionality. You can start to build out specific topics. The access to actions is completely there. There's a lot more knowledge sources you can work with than just the SharePoint and toggling on that website knowledge source. And you can build one of these agents with all of that richness involved and then bring it back inside that Microsoft 365 Copilot in that same user experience way that we just saw. If you'd like to learn more about how to build in Copilot Studio, check out my tutorial here. Let me know what else you'd like to learn about. I'm all over this stuff and can't wait to share more with you. Thanks for watching.